Hello, my name is Sikai. I'm an application engineer with Keysight Technologies. In this video, I'm going to show you how to characterize the current consumptions of a wearable devices such as the Fitband that I have over here. Wearable devices typically draw very low current in the standby modes and a higher current in the operating modes. To characterize the current consumptions, I'm going to use the Keysight True Digital Multimeter, the 34470A. Before I get started, let me go ahead and disassemble this Fitbands and connect it to the digital multimeters. So now we have the Fitbands disassembled, and I'm connecting the digital multimeters in series with the battery and the PC board. So now I have the device in the standby mode, and the multimeter is securely reading in the microamp range. Over here is the nanoamps and pico-amp range over here. And the device now is actually drawing about 2.2 nanoamps currents in the standby mode. So now the Fitband is in the normal operating mode. As you can see, the number is actually changing quite a bit. I'm going to turn the display mode to trend chart. As you can see, the current is actually jumping up and down. For more details on the readings, I'm going to turn on the statistic. Over here, you can see the minimum current drawn from the battery is about 4 microamps, and the maximum current is about 2.3 milliamps. I'm going to turn on the blue lights on the Fitband and see how much current draws. Okay, and this will be the blue lights, it's about 40 milliamps, and green lights. Right, it's slightly lower than the blue lights here. Maybe a vibrations mode, it will draw more currents. Right. So you can see the trend chart actually gives us very clear readings. The maximum reading now is from the current, the draw from the battery is 40 milliamps. Well, let's say if you're interested in seeing finer details on how much current is drawn by these Fitbands, you can actually do this by using the digitizing modes. So in this case, I'm setting the sampling rate to 10,000 readings per second and for durations of 5 seconds. Once this is done, I'll hit the start button. And the digitizing completed. And to view the data, I'm going to switch to the trend chart and zoom in to see finer details. And also pan around to the data point that I'm interested in. I can also turn on the cursor to track the cursor and to move the cursor to the peaks to get the current values on the charts. And further to this, I can also save for the readings, the digitized readings into the pen drive or by connecting to a computer. Well, as you can see, the digital multimeter has some great features for characterizing low current consumption devices. If you'd like to learn more, please visit our website or subscribe to our YouTube channel for more interesting videos. Thank you for watching.